this is your main event on ESPN. And I got to tell you something, Ralphie. There are a lot of tag teams that are not real happy about it. I mean, the Destruction Crew, the heavyweight champions of the world, the tag team champions. You can see their belt. But the challengers this afternoon, DJ Peterson and Rick McCord, I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you what. We saw them last week in a pretty impressive debut here.
Yeah.
And right away, they're getting shots. But Texas Hangman upset. They wanted this match. Other tag teams wanted this match as well, not the least of which the Lumberjacks.
The Lumberjacks are furious. They wanted a shot at the Destruction Crew.
But it's the Crew right away, and they're hot and heavy and furious and getting it on.
There's Rick McCord, partner of DJ Peterson. And make no mistake about it, these young men did not get the opportunity to be the tag team champions of the world by winning some sort of jingle contest. They are the former Central States tag team champions. Now the Destruction Crew having their way with DJ Peterson. Mean Mike Enos picks him up for the slam, puts him in the middle of the ring, says, I think I got a special delivery for you right here.
Oh, right against the ring post. And I'll tell you what, the Destruction Crew has successfully defended their title every time. I want to ask you this. Looks like they've gained some weight.
Oh, yeah.
In the person of Christopher Love, who's hanging by ringside. I mean, what's Love doing in the Crew's?
Oh, did you see that double clothesline by DJ Peterson? Double drop kick, and the Crew is down.
These two guys we saw last week, they work in concert mighty well together. McCord and Peterson, and you know, it is no accident they're here today. We've talked about the speculation that there's other teams very upset, but these two guys belong here based on their merits and based on AWA Joe Blanchard, President Joe Blanchard's signing, saying, okay, go ahead, guys, do it.
Well, they were impressive. We saw them before. They look great, and there's the guy you were talking about, too, Ralph. Christopher Love. He first came into the AWA, bringing in a man that he originally managed, for those of you that are wrestling trivia buffs. He was the original manager of the Super Brat, Tully Blanchard, and he brought Blanchard back into the AWA. Then all of a sudden, he shows up with Lord Humongous.
Oh, yeah.
How did you describe him? 6'8", 10,000 pounds?
9'4", 9,385 pounds. Big guy. And now he's here with the Crew now.
Look at this. Who is this guy? Who is this guy?
I've seen him earlier. We've seen him earlier.
Oh, okay.
Very strangely garbed, I don't know what he is doing here, but
I'm not going to make anything out of it that it might not be. I mean,
no.
People come to wrestling matches a lot of the times like they come to NFL games.
That's right.
I mean, see the way people are dressed coming there? Jeez Louise, Mike Enos whipping DJ. Look out! Look out!
DJ quickly out of the way.
Arm drag by Peterson, tag made. Here comes young Rick McCord.
Oh!
Right onto the left arm of Mean Mike Enos, and Chris Love does not like that.
Not one bit. And there's no way that he should like that, because right now the Crew really needs to turn it around. There's Enos getting back to Crew. Wow, McCord was waiting.
What a great move by Rick McCord. Tremendous move.
And we saw Rick McCord very quick last week. Again, we see him this week, the former Central States champions, these two, going to work here on the Crew. The belt's on the line.
They have been a team, I would wager to say, as long as the Destruction Crew. They did split up for a little while. Here comes DJ right onto the left arm of Wayne the Train Bloom. Referee saying, watch yourself. Ooh, look at that grapevine. Grapevine the arm into a bar, into a, almost a scissors on the top of the throat as well. DJ Peterson's got him wrapped up like a Christmas package, Ralph.
And the referee looking out, as you mentioned, is Gary DeRuscia, one of the very best in the business. Gets the call for this title match, and wow, what a great pace. I'm wondering which team can outlast the other. Very quick pace for this match.
Incredibly big pace for big guys. You know, when you see big guys wrestle, Ralph, a lot of times you'll see them slow up just because they can't keep up that rigorous pace. But you got some monster guys in there. The Destruction Crew, DJ Peterson. I mean, these are big, big men, and they are just going at it like they're doing 40-yard dashes. Oh, by DJ. And he's going to town on both Bloom and Enos. Back into the arm drag, and the Train is looking to get off the tracks.
Train
wants to tag.
Train tried to tag one of the cameramen up there in the corner. I mean, he is very disoriented right now. DJ Peterson really going to work.
Referee admonishing Christopher Love, and now both Peterson and McCord in. Double-teaming Wayne the Train Bloom, double arm drag. And now McCord working on the left arm.
Well, you mentioned four big men in the ring. The smallest is McCord, and he goes 232.
Yeah, it's tough to be 232 pounds, 6'2", and have someone call you tiny. That'll give you an idea just how big these men are. And strong, when you talk about strong, Wayne Bloom for 3 years, winning consecutively. Look at this! Backdrop by McCord.
Great move by McCord.
I do want to finish my thought on Wayne Bloom, 3 years running, powerlifting champion of the world.
And he's going to need all his strength today.
I'll tell you, if McCord twists that arm one more time, Bloom's not going to be able to lift a cup of coffee, let alone the weight.
Frantic pace. And McCord and Peterson really setting tempo, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely. And now McCord into a front chancery, still holding on to the arm. Takes Bloom into the corner. Reversal by Wade. Reversal by McCord. What a heads-up move by Rick McCord into the monkey flip. And right onto the AWA logo, Fanny first goes the train.
Train is in big-time trouble right now, Lee Marshall.
Back into the standing arm bar. Mike Enos making a little motion into the middle of the ring. And here comes DJ.
Wayne Bloom complaining about the tag, but referee Gary DeRuscia was turned the other way.
Tough job DeRuscia's got.
Unbelievable, especially with four men this pumped up.
Oh, yeah, because it's all on the line here. Destruction Crew, they want to hold on to those AWA Tag Team Championship belts. Christopher Love, he's already talking about everywhere he's taken the Destruction Crew to defend. They're going to go to Tokyo, Japan very, very soon to defend there.
Well, they got
to take him to the Soviet Union as well.
Oh!
But they got to get by Peterson and McCord this afternoon on ESPN.
I was going to say, they need belts to go on those road trips.
Tag made. Here comes Mean Mike Enos.
Oh!
Drop toe hold by DJ. What a quick move.
Incredible.
And Christopher Love, he's coming undone over this.
Tremendous move by DJ Peterson. And you mentioned, I mean, Chris Love is just beside himself.
Look at this, setting him up for the monkey flip. He launched him. DJ launched Mike Enos, and here comes Peterson. Oh! Oh, my God. Oh!
Oh, my. Oh, my teeth clenched just watching that.
That could be the one miscalculation that could mean the match for the Destruction Crew. DJ Peterson, right into the small of the back. The big half-hawk arm, away the train loom. Reverse suplex, and down goes Peterson. He's rocked, Ralphie.
Oh, he is really rocked. He was dishing it out on one end, and now it's Wayne the Train Bloom coming back after that big miss in the corner. Look at the train. I mean, these two guys, the Destruction Crew, don't just have the belts. They have earned them, and they have kept them. They have defended the title well.
Oh, yeah.
And you got to beat these two guys, and the fighting is rounds.
You lose again!
The Destruction Crew has got a real attitude. Double elbow by the crew.
They are so great!
Because they had Christopher Love. This is so great. This is so great.
Yeah.
One, two, kick out. When they talk about the belts, they say they're my belts. They're our belts. I mean, we know that not to be true, but that's the attitude. Power slam by Mean Mike. One, two. Out by DJ.
But that is an attitude, Lee, that has kept them on their waists.
That's right.
So you can't question success, especially success when it comes to Mike Enos and Wayne Bloom.
Got to agree with you there, huh? Absolutely right. Laying the weight down. Really putting the weight down. Reverse chin lock. Referee checked. It is not a joke. He said it's clean.
Shut up.
Coming back. Rallying the troops. Rallying
the
support.
He's trying.
Very clear. Which side? The bandera.
He's on his feet. Peterson is up. Elbow into the midsection. Another elbow. Forearm by Mike Enos. Into the ropes goes Peterson. Said, get me out of here.
Holy cow.
Wayne the Train hooks him up, takes him vertical, got him. Suplex could be it.
Beautiful suplex by Wayne Bloom.
One,
the casual
two,
cover.
Three. No, only the two count. You're right, a little bit cavalier on that cover, Ralph.
He surely was, you know. I mean, he had D.J. Peterson finally at the point he wanted him. Now continuing to soften him up, and in comes Enos.
That's a couple of big body slams D.J. Peterson has taken. And now here comes mean Mike Enos. Headbutt. Into the back of the head by Mean Mike. Got DJ by the hair, picking him up for the slam. Boom, right in the middle of the ring. And now scrubs his boot across the forehead of DJ Peterson.
Enos looking pretty confident now. Goes to the second rope. Got a big smile on his face. Oh!
Did a little too much posturing. A little too much showboating up there on that second rope. Gave Peterson enough of an opportunity to clear his head and tossing him out a little bit.
And look at Peterson trying to get to the tag. He got there before Enos did.
Here comes McCord. Rick McCord's in. He's just looking for someone to hit. And he's got Wade the Train Bloom.
Off of the ropes.
Backdrop. He planted him like a tree. Big right hand into the forehead of Mike Enos. Body slamming. Down goes Bloom.
All four men in the ring. Now Peterson outside of it.
Going for the stretch. Locking him on the abdominal stretch.
But look at DJ.
Peterson's got to get out of the ring, otherwise the referee is not going to even check on the possibility of a submission. Here comes Bloom.
From off the top rope, but Nerusha had to deal with DJ Peterson.
And Enos has got a hold of McCord, the two.
Oh!
Oh, did you see the lady at ringside shaking her head going, oh, no. Peterson got in Darusha's way as well. Let's have another look at it.
Absolutely. You see in the background, Darusha's head is turned. You see in the foreground, the damage done. Wayne Bloom sneaks out of the ring, and Mike Enos goes for the cover just in time for Darusha to count it down. The crew keeps the belts.
Here they are, the tag team champions of the world. Let's check in now with Eric Bischoff.
Wrestling fans, for weeks now, experts all over the country have been naming the tag team of DJ Peterson and Rick McCord as a tag team that most likely stands a chance to take the titles away from the Destruction Crew. But unfortunately, guys, it wasn't today.
This is not an interview. This is a promise. This is a promise going out to all you people. This is a promise going out to Wayne Bloom and Mike Enos. I don't care when it is. One of these days, boys, the time is going to come where you're not going to be able to do that kind of stuff. Somebody's going to catch you. A referee, two referees. I don't give a damn, make it no DQ. But I want the World Tag Team Championships. And I got my buddy back from Kansas City, Missouri. We used to be Central States Tag Team Champions. And I'll tell you what.